Now to Victoria's flood emergency, and the focus is moving to the state's northwest corner. Swan Hill and Mildura are next in line. Along with Wentworth just across the border, Horsham and Dimboola are mopping up. Kerang remains cut off, but levees are holding. As the water recedes, the growing impact of these floods is being revealed. TEN's Melanie Davies is in the flood zone.
As the water subsides here in Horsham, the sandbags are being stacked and the clean-up has begun. The damage bill will soar into the millions. The Wimmera River has surged through several towns, the latest to Parrot and at Beulah. Fortunately, though, fewer houses have been affected than first feared. Swan Hill and Mildura are next. Both centres have been put on high alert. Now, it's difficult to comprehend the sheer volume of water in the state without taking to the skies. Today, the Governor-General did just that while on a whirlwind tour of flood-affected towns. Bringing a much-needed morale boost, the Governor-General touched down in the flood zone. Her first stop, Horsham, to be greeted by the Mayor. Then taken to the retirement village.
Many people here have been through an enormous anxiety.
Just 2 days ago, it was surrounded by water and residents were evacuated.
The girls and the men did a wonderful job in moving it.
It was quite an experience, but everything went off very well.
Fortunately, it didn't go under, and they're now settling back in. Ms. Bryce also met residents where several homes were affected.
It was full of water. The street was completely filled.
In Pepper Tree Lane, carpets have been pulled up, but there's still a long way to go.
Was it scary?
It was a bit scary.
The Governor-General making her way south after seeing the devastation in Queensland.
What we've seen is the deep care and concern underpinned by that unique Australian toughness.
That spirit will be tested again in coming days. SES crews bracing for water from Kerang to hit Swan Hill over the weekend, while Mildura is preparing for a surge mid-next week.
Got a couple of drains that flow out or valves in the levee bank. We've turned all those off so the water can't flow back through into the park at this stage, and we're just keeping a close eye on it.
The state government has unveiled a series of flood grants and emergency funds to help individuals and businesses. Melanie Davies, 10 News.